Montpellier's bench is not as strong as it once was, but they can still boast the likes of Nicolas Mas and Thomas Kombezou. The biggest boost for Ulster this week is John Afoa is back, the All Black, and how timely that is. Well, Mark Anscombe was satisfied with the win over Tigers last Friday at Ravenhill, but there was an acknowledgement that they can play better, and this reaction to victory over double Heineken Cup champions and European giants Leicester shows not just their ambition, and a realistic ambition at that, but also just how far Ulster have come in terms of being classed amongst Europe's big boys, reaching the knockout phases in the last three seasons, and of course finalists 2 years ago. Today, Tyrone Howe, will be another stern test of their Heineken Cup credentials.
It will, Johnny. It literally doesn't get any bigger than this. One of, if not arguably, the biggest packs in European rugby. But it's going to be a massively physical test for Ulster, but they're going to have to draw on some serious self-belief. They got the win against Leicester last week. They believe they can play a lot better. And they also went away to the Ospreys 2 weeks ago and got a crucial away victory in the Rabo. It's those sort of experiences that you draw on, but it promises to be a bruising encounter.
They've played 108 games in this fantastic tournament, winning the thing back in 1999, but they've never won in France until round five of last season's pool stages. At the Stade Pierre-Antoine in Cassis, who's a huge monkey, no, a gorilla off their backs. And now with a win over the Tigers, they seek to repeat the feat and win back-to-back games on French soil today.
Well, in these sort of big games, you need your experienced players to stand up and be counted. Johan Muller leading the pack out there really needs a big game. Tommy Bowe, need to see him getting into the frame, get the ball into his hands early. It's possible that Ulster has the edge out wide, but they've got to get at least parity up front to get the ball flashing out that three-quarter line.
Seven changes for Fabien Galthié's side, who looks far more like a first-choice side, far more like the sides that hosted Toulouse and Clermont earlier in the top 14 this season and won. Captain Houlagence Juan Drago comes into the side with the oval ball gladiator that is Mamuka Kogodzi. Well, they're novices in the Heineken Cup, aren't they, really? Only their third outing. And in this tournament, you have to earn your spurs, but it's a statement. What a fine side they are. They reached the quarterfinals last time out, coming out of a pool that contained Toulon, the eventual champions.
They're big, they're fast, they're skillful, they've got experience, they're well coached. You see Fabien Galthié there. But they are relatively novice in Europe, got the quarters last year, but I just wonder, can Ulster surprise them? They did it last year at Castra, but Montpellier will be wanting to get out of the blocks quickly and make a bold statement early in this game.
Leighton Hodges from Wales is the man with a P in the middle. Dry so far, forecast for a bit of rain. Fantastic atmosphere, fantastic stadium, two fantastic teams, both winners in round one. This is all set up for another Heineken Cup Classic.
Don't block four.
One of the biggest problems Fabien Galthié has had this season is integrating a lot of new players that came in the summer. There's some money spent, integrated seven with the Montpellier faithful, the likes of Tranduc and Juan Drago. The first penalty is conceded by the visitors.
Don't come across, run straight.
Ulster will be disappointed with that because there were just signs of early jitters, the high ball being spilled. Rory Best in there quickly, and the referee correct, Chris Henry, has to come from behind. Rory Best come in through the gate, just found himself on the wrong side. Before the game we saw both sets of kickers kicking everything from within the halfway range. It seemed to be well within both kickers' distances. Bit blustery down there as well.
Certainly is. Wind slightly behind the back of Montpellier and Anthony Frosch. He's taking this long range effort, of course, Francois Tranduc, normally the first choice goal kicker. Anthony Frosch came over from Clermont, didn't he? Probably grew up in the summer. Taking this long range effort, it's going to be White. Let up for Ulster. But he certainly had the distance, and it'll just put question marks in the minds of the men in white, Ulster.
Well, Flush has that distance in his boot. And Ulster, very early reminder that they cannot afford to give away cheap penalties in any sort of kickable position.
And Montpellier, like the Irish provinces, stock has been rising significantly of late. Very professional victory over Benetton Treviso over in Italy last weekend. Back at home, different beast though, like most French sides. And immediately they're away with Agusa, the former Ulsterman. Diak goes back, brought into the side with that injury to Nick Williams. Group Pinar is told to use it now by the referee.
White.
It's Luke Marshall. Just about clears, but Nagusa loved his time in Belfast, didn't he? Really good friends with Darren Cave, even maybe one of his sons after Darren.
Well, I just got a taste of what this Montpellier backline is capable of. And the ball bounced unkindly for Jared Tent, with Robbie Diak in there. And you see there are numbers in defence, but just gets out side Rory Best and just sucks in Andrew Trimble.
Contact in the air, be very careful, it's just a penalty this time, okay?
Tantui being warned by referee Hodges, and some early penalties being given away here for Ulster. Not what you want to do away from home, especially in France. Get their tails up, big crowd here, hardly a seat spare, and this place does absolutely rock when their side get going.
Again, there's some mild contact made there, and almost it's as much the Montpellier supporting players not bringing the jumper down properly, but a much easier attempt at 3 points. But also playing into a very stiff breeze, they'd be wanting to stay tight to this Montpellier side and not allow them to build up much of an early lead.
Well, Tranduc can kick and often does. Pellisse, Jonathan Pellisse is the man. Take this second penalty kick, the informed scrum half in the top 14. He makes no mistake, it's 3-0 to Montpellier. Got a feeling we may well see him in French colours during the autumn test series with Morgan Parra, banned for 4 weeks. Marchelot, a broken bone in his hand in that first round. Felice really is the informed scrum half, lightning pace off the mark, and there's Privat, the veteran, another man, formerly of Clermont Auvergne, in the second row with Scotland international Jim Hamilton, the former Gloucester captain, of course.
Really good chase from Andrew Trimble there, putting Privat under all sorts of pressure, made the tackle, but a very good clearance kick.
Middle is here, stay where you are.
Trimble gets up, makes a tackle, two in behind him. But it's well recovered by Montpellier.
Whole new front row for Montpellier today. And Vachumen, Ivaldi and Maximilian Bustos. It's that man, Rory Brest, gets a scrum time. Captain the Lions, didn't he, in the summer? Against the Brumbies. Nagusa gets a hand to it and goes out, and a little bit of luck for Ulster, and they will have the put into the line out.
Well, they need to spend some time down in this Montpellier half just to set up camp, go through a few phases, just ask a few questions of this Montpellier defence. But you mentioned that strength and depth of the Montpellier side. It's a hallmark of the better French sides, but also now have a much stronger squad, strength and depth in every position.
There's criticism laid at them, wasn't it? Years gone by, great starting 15, but not too much to go off the bench. Not the case nowadays. And you look at Afoa, Henderson holding, man is really coming up the ranks. Here's Chris Henry, player of the year 2012. Trimble, take it, just took his eyes off it, didn't he? Sean Agusa, his old friend, coming up against him.
Well, the French midfield defence coming up very hard in the middle of the pitch, but there was plenty of space out wide, actually. If Chris Henry had maybe been able to get the ball away earlier in that movement. But Trimble just slightly took his eyes off the ball there. Under pressure, Olafia right in his face. It's a big afternoon for Ulster's back row. Three very intelligent players, but you wonder how much is it going to hurt the side not having the bulk of Nick Williams early in this game.
And it was a question mark whether Henderson would come in on the blind side or, as it is, Robbie Diak. I think that experience, I think, is probably the call. Is it extra line-out option as well?
Well, you've got to back yourself that the players will give everything in his opening 50, 60 minutes, and if they can stay close to Montpellier, well then there's a very experienced, very talented bench to unleash. And you bring, you know, Foa, Henderson, Olding, as worked last week with Pienaar coming on as well. You know, you've got a chance to try and get even closer to sneak it. I suppose it's a battle for those players on the pitch, and then you just try and bring on the cavalry.
Big ask though, isn't it, for the first 50 or 60 minutes. Top of the top 14, well, second place, only on points difference to Toulon, Montpellier. Of course, the new scrum engagement laws. Crouch, bind, and then set. Trying to negate all the scrums going to deck. Declan Fitzpatrick at a really nasty bump on the nose last week at Ravenhill. But the scrum grew, didn't it? Tom Court had an excellent second half against Dan Cole. And that scrum has not gone the way of Tom Court. You can see him on the far side wearing number one, complaining to the assistant referee. There's Declan Fitzpatrick, and that knows you were down there and on the pitch side last week.
You say a bump, Johnny. I saw Declan's nose afterwards, and you could virtually see the bone underneath the cut. It was just an X cut, just skin openly showing the bone. And it's extraordinary that he's even able to make it onto the pitch. But there you see the body angle of Tom Court all over the place under so much pressure from this front row. And amazing to think that Montpellier have changed their whole front row from last week, leaving people like Nicolas Mass on the bench.
Nine out doesn't go the way of Montpellier. Instead, it's with Paddy Jackson, who's bang in form at the moment, isn't he? Paddy Jackson to the flush. Goes high. Trimble, he was practicing those before kickoff. Jared Payne, the New Zealander, such a classy operator. Godzik up against Wilson. There's Fitzpatrick.
Timon.
Pass from Jared Payne. It was Ruan Pienaar. Oh, they had a break in 2013, straight from the rugby championship into Heineken Cup duty. Trimble trying to chase this one. Flosch was manhandled slightly this court. Diak has missed out for Paddy Jackson. Marshall. Is this with a bouncing field? It does. Fine kick for a man who announced himself on the international stage in the Six Nations.
Lovely death kick under pressure. The Montpellier number 8 pointed it back up, but he knew fine well inside the line. Great kick. Montpellier looking slightly susceptible under the high ball. And one of Ruan Pienaar's great strengths. And as he did, you know, last week, and Jackson last week, you know, that the Leicester Tigers back three didn't look overly comfortable. It's one thing you don't want to do is, you know, offer any incentive. Jackson kept on peppering the wings. You can imagine Pienaar putting up even more high balls.
We've got three kicking options, haven't you, outside of Jared Payne. It was a fourth, really, with Marshall and Jackson as well as Pienaar. But Privat has taken the line out. Pelisse pedaling is Tommy Bowe. British and Irish line, Tommy Bowe, try score last week. It's a good pass, isn't it? To Darren Kay. and sighted it to Trimble. Now there's a chance here. Tommy Bow back to Trimble, steps inside. Ulster were looking for a start here. It's exactly what they've got. Beautifully worked down the left touchline. Trimble looked rusty last week, anything but there.
Magnificent try from Ulster. You see the different tactics in the kicking games. Just Montpellier hoofing it down the pitch. Payne spots the space on the outside. And what a pass from Darren Cave. Didn't even have to look. Just sense Trimble there. And then the two wingers combining. And Trimble just getting a few extra yards. Beautiful try. What counter-attacking. Darren Cave, that is the pass that makes that try, taking two players out. Superb.
First try, Heineken Cup duty for Ulster, top try scorer for the Irish province. Jackson striking it so well before the game. No reason for that not to be the case for that conversion. Montpellier rocked here.
That pass from Darren Cave, it is so skillful. Just take a look up, he knew where Trimble was, gave the ball full pace without even looking. Brilliant vision from Cave and great finishing between Bow and Trimble.
As soon as Bow got the ball, he sensed it, didn't he? Dangerous back three, experienced back three as well. But Darren Cave, love to see that again. The eyes, just watch the eyes, just fix the defender purely with the eyeballs. Bow is chasing this one. Galtier just about takes it, but then he's bundled into touch. And this huge travelling support here from Ulster. They've been flying in all over France, Spain as well, and getting the train up. Huge amount of them here.
Well, the noise level's just gone up ever so slightly again from the Ulster supporters, because it's the high ball jinx really catching out this Montpellier back three.
This is a Montpellier side smashed 19 times, champions of the top 14 to lose. And back that up with a 43 points to 3 hammering of Clermont earlier this season. Montpellier saying, oh, got to watch him. Juan Pienaar and Johan Muller are there. Ulster penalty. All going the way of Ulster at the moment.
Just putting the pressure on. You just thought he might sneak through, but Juan Pienaar, the sweeper, just providing enough on the ball. And then Rory Best. Wow, we've seen him do that for a long, long time. So difficult, that low centre of gravity. Now look at four Montpellier players trying to grapple him off the ball.
But mine being described as a limpet over the ball there. Barnacle. They do have a fabulous home record. Never beaten in this competition here at the Stade Yves de Manoir. And you have to go back 13 months to Racing Metro's visit here to find when they last lost in any competition, a run of 18 games. The task is a stiff one for Ulster, but a task at the moment. They are meeting head on. Ruin Pienaar. Asked David Humphreys, the director of rugby for Ulster, who would be kicking. Paddy Jackson is the number one kicker, but is slightly further out, and Ruin Pienaar is the man. Not bad to have two kickers of this kind of quality in the Ulster ranks. Every point matters in this competition, especially away from home. Bounces off the post. And not a fear. Man quickest to react this Springbok. Tran Duke. Nice subplot there, isn't it? Down to his opposite number, Paddy Jackson. Two men playing for their hometowns. I saw Tran Duke again, another man. With Joachim Felice having a excellent start to the top 14, but not required by Philippe Saint-André in their autumn squad, which not a head-scratching selection from Philippe Saint-André.
Well, Ulster have done very well to play themselves into this game, aided by a few French mistakes, and with one opportunity converted. And that try from Andrew Trimble, they'd be delighted with the way they currently sit in this game.
As I mentioned already, that high ball is a definite tactic of Ulster. Looked at that. 22-16 it was against Leicester. Leicester coming away with a lose and a bonus point. Fascinating round of ties. Dramatic finish at Wembley last night for Toulouse. Magusa and Henry that went forward off Magusa.
There'll be a big sigh of relief there because the bounce of the ball came back on the Montpellier side and then an overlap. But Magusa just getting up, knocking the ball on. You saw Diak in the line out before taking the ball. I think that's maybe one of the reasons that Diak has been preferred to Henderson early in this game. Henderson going to be unleashed off the bench, one imagines, in the second half. And Anscombe likes Henderson coming on, that impact player. And Diak has been in good form this season and just maybe gives a little bit of solidity in that line out at the back.
Henderson, very much the impact sub.
Okay, we talked before the game.
Huge
about
man.
Being in the engaged, in the crouch position, year on year. We're too far apart. You need to step up onto the mark.
It's amazing to think, Ian Henderson could start for Ireland in the Autumn Internationals and yet coming off the bench for Ulster, but certainly you would expect. The way you see Niall Malone and David Humphreys. Humphreys on the right there. He wanted it to stay dry here because he wanted to move the ball about, move this gigantic Montpellier pack around. And so far, so good, although the forecast is maybe for a little bit of rain as the game goes on.
It's warm though, isn't it? Shirt sleeves weather. And the scrum goes back. Mikel Ivaldi, warned by the referee, standing a little bit closer. Who came from right through the Toulon Academy, signed in the summer. Huge amount of players, and like 15 that joined Montpellier in the summer. We've still got the likes of Rennie Ranger, the Blues man, Robert Everson, South African centre, and
bind, set,
Timani, the Wallaby international. It's a little unsure that he's coming or not. He's definitely in the Australian squad to tour the autumn. He's still to come into the squad. Ruben Pienaar tackled. A little bit messy, wasn't it, between Roger Wilson and Ruben Pienaar, but they've come up with a penalty. Police say just a little too eager to get in on his man.
Well, some you win and some you lose, and this is one that Ulster definitely won. I mean, the ball came out, the referee was quite clear about it. Police say obviously thought, well, just Jouet, just get in there and put pressure on. But the penalty going Ulster's way.
You can see that given the other way, can't you? But Ruben Pienaar, all that international experience, 71 caps for the Springboks. Leaving the ball alone. Police tackling him, Leighton Hodges giving the penalty, and Paddy Jackson now. Fourth kicker we've seen already. Tries to add to his tally. Conversion already. It's gone wide of the posts. It's two misses for Ulster. One for Montpellier. That's 6 points down the drain, as it were, for Ulster. Will that be an issue? Come a final whistle.
Seven away.
Neat little taking kickoff in between Tranduk and Privat. Payne.
White, seven, hold.
Okay. Well, he started in the Rabodrek Pro 12 final, which of course also reached last season. Flush, good angle from the fullback, looking to get the ball away, wasn't he, to Tua Tavaki. Hamilton now. Rodri. To reset. Priva, 34 years of age, still up. Huge work rate on the man. Bustos, the Argentinian. Picked up a couple of caps for Argentina in the summer. Wasn't involved in the rugby championship. Kochemin. Tranduk. Look at that space just behind the, off the first line of defence. Paddy Jackson was there though. That sort of sweeper role. Pienaar. Charged down by Hamilton and Priva.
Away black, it's been
a pretty decent kick to get over those two. Boat. Hagley loves to run. In amongst the forwards. Montpellier looking for that ball. Crowd incensed by the decision by referee Leighton Hodges.
Again, Ulster getting the rub of the green in that one, because Tommy, he just thought, might have been slightly isolated, bit of player over the ball. But one, he's got to stay completely on his feet. And players coming in behind, I think, didn't help either. But the referee certainly on Ulster's side there. Really, route one rugby, big ball carriers from Montpellier. From an Ulster point of view, that's a great sound to hear, this Montpellier support booing, jeering the referee, and it is certainly not the sort of atmosphere so far in this game that you associate with Toulouse at home, Clermont at home, Toulon at home. The crowd being silenced by this Ulster side, and Mark Anscombe and David Humphreys will be very happy.
So a shot of Mario Ledesma, legendary Argentina hooker. He was at Clermont, wasn't he, for so many years. $1 fear. Just come off the field. Viscompa Zou is on. Early change in the midfield then for Montpellier. Tranduc upends Marshall. Johan Muller leads the side so well. Pienaar, of course, just signed a new 3-year deal. Jackson says to Montpellier, you go back, you play from there. Sensible, intelligent rugby from a man who's only 21 years of age.
It is, it's calm, it's patient, it's composed. The ball carrier's doing the job. It's not on, although there was maybe a slight overlap out wide there, but very intelligent kick through from Jackson, just keeping the pressure.
Drago with a line out. Now the maul is set. 3 points to 7. Ulster are up. The problem with the score clock for our host broadcaster here. Early try for Andrew Trimble on the right wing. He's wearing 14 anyway, Andrew Trimble. More on the left at the moment. Jackson again. Rush takes the mark. As far as Montpellier can say, he just get into this game, get some rhythm, get some territory and possession.
Ulster will be delighted. You know, they're playing the game in the right parts of the pitch. They're forcing Montpellier to kick, which is allowing Ulster get their hands on the ball, dominate possession, frustrate this Montpellier side. And you know, as we've seen for a long time, you frustrate these French sides, they do tend to be indisciplined, they do tend to give away penalties. Black.
And Tui. Lively colour of undergarment for Dan Tui. Glow in the dark stuff. I think we'll leave it there, shall we? His second row partner, Johan Muller. takes the line out. Now Oster showing all the strings against a huge Montpellier pack, we must say that. There was hope rather than expectation around the ground from the supporters in white and red. Flosh again, Jackson just landing it right outside the 22. Gorgodzi has been penalised. They were playing advantage from the referee.
Well, 2 points of real encouragement there. That latter one, the high ball again, putting Flosh not really under a huge amount of pressure, but even more importantly, the driven maul there, putting a bigger, bulkier, more physical, heavier pack on the front foot. That'll give massive confidence to this Ulster pack. Gorgodzi, you just see coming in at the side, Diak at the front.
Back in the side, tore his calf back in August in training. They call Gorgodzilla. Incredible work rate. Now Ruan Pienaar lines up another attempt at goal. He's missed one. Paddy Jackson has missed one. Can't afford to miss too many. Know there's going to be a reaction from Montpellier at some point. Just about got the legs, not the direction again. They can't add to their total of seven. But they are playing rugby in the right areas, i.e. Montpellier's half.
They are, but yeah, they would have loved to have converted at least one, if not two, of these missed opportunities with the boot. Normally you'd be expecting Pienaar and Jackson to slot the vast majority of those.
It's funny, isn't it? Both those kickers, Pienaar and Jackson, striking the ball so well before the game. It's just padded back by Pellice again. This high ball is causing real, real problems for Montpellier.
And Ulster sense it, and that chasing line, really aggressive, big tempo. Tom Court out of the blocks there, and Luke Marshall. It's just a swell of pressure. Montpellier so far not dealing with it particularly well.
Jan Odrin. Bundled into touch by Luke Watts. Marshall, I should say.
My good gods, he's got his man in the middle there.
One stop.
Of course, Paddy Wallace, the man who often has worn the 12 shirt for Ulster. Still struggling with a raft of injuries. Didn't find a bad replacement, did they, Luke Marshall? Again, confusion in Montpellier's scramble defence.
Use it!
Pellice tried to score against Treviso last week in that 27 points to 10 win. Here's Jared Payne, such a classy operator. Looks inside now. Henry, Ruan Pienaar outside. He wants quick ball now. The South African scrum half. Votremain has got his hands all over the ball. But legally, says the referee, there was an opportunity to move the ball there from Chris Henry. You can understand how plenty of bodies around him, why he didn't do it.
Well, the pass to him just, it was just, it stopped him in his tracks. He did so well getting it. But what a counter-attacking run from Jared Payne. But the pass then to Henry, lateral, forced him to turn, took sort of the momentum out of the movement. And just showing against a wall of black jerseys there, just unlocking the door.
Middle here, okay.
Fabio Galtier, along with Mario Ledesma, coaching staff here in Montpellier. What style of rugby, willingness to run the ball. They need that now, don't they? They need to hold on to the ball, first of all. Luke Marshall.
Advantage over.
Tommy Bowe. Advantage is over, just pops the ball up. It's great hands from Dan Toohey. got down really well for a big man, then just tries to flick the ball out. Diak is there. It has gone forward, says the referee.
Yeah, it's just led forward, like.
Intent and ambition again from Ulster.
It's the first real passage of play from Montpellier we've seen. Ball off the back of the line out, Udrago, and then just flashing it across the pitch, the right lines, but the spilled ball giving possession to Ulster. Down to be a bit disappointed that ball either wasn't held on to or just didn't get popped backwards.
He thought it was going to be held up, this choke tackle.
Well, both of them were so upright there as they hit contact, very difficult to get the ball back.
All in all, David Humphreys will be happy with the start here from Ulster. Saw Glasgow down at Stade Mayor last weekend in Toulon. Freeze.
Just both gone down.
They're not entirely sure why, but just froze.
Let's move this way a little, lads.
In front of big French side on their turf. Not the case here for Ulster. Been away to France, of course. Win over Castres. 9 points to 8, but still a win. And they take a similar 1 point win today, wouldn't they? Gatier, under 20 international, Montpellier down at the moment, 3 points to 7. Police say here's Tranduc to a Tavaki. The old fashioned scissor ball. Tranduc, a wonderful rugby player, all over the field this afternoon. Shouldn't be surprised, this is the Heineken Cup. Ragusa now. Ogodzi. Tackled by his opposite number, Henry. Played on his hands this afternoon, Chris Henry. Now Montpellier just beginning to get into their stride. First of the commentator, they knock it on, but it's gone backwards. Police again, Tranduc. He was fired out from Combezou, Flash can't take it. Just not themselves at the moment, Montpellier.
Tommy Vaux did very well, sensed his the pace he needed to come up, great sense of space as well, managed to get in the face and just managed to create that little error and knocking the ball on. Big ball carrying there, but Ulster defending very well, not throwing anybody into the ruck other than the tackler. Tommy Vaux up to make that tackle, puts pressure on, and Ulster live again. Not too many gaps out there in this Ulster defence. Defence coach Johnny Bell will be absolutely delighted. Now they have not shipped too many tries in recent matches.
Just have the front row up,
and there's a real front belief row. In that defensive system.
Just
they come up aggressively off the line.
Just the front row.
Tackler makes the hit, and they're not committing too many to the ruck, so able to fan across the pitch.
Okay, first and foremost, okay.
Anthony Flosh, who has his own high standards, has not had a good start to this game.
If you don't close it up,
taken off.
Okay, and then you need to get
30 minutes into this game. He's dropped virtually everything that's come his way.
Is that clear? Okay.
Young man, Benoit Sika, has come on. Normally a fly half.
Knock on black here, yeah?
His first professional season. What a baptism of fire to come in at fullback, especially when Ulster are peppering these high balls up.
Real final talking to both the packs. The last scrum was a mess. I think the referee was just quite happy that the ball came out at all, but you wonder at what point will he start showing yellow cards, and at what point, you know, which side will they be we given to?
Too far away.
Free kick. Montpellier have been warned. Just dropping back, sitting back on the second row, the front row there. Edging away, and Ruan Pina says to the young man, just come on the field, you can take that one. He doesn't.
Forward off black.
Drago has taken it, but it's come off a Montpellier hand, so referee playing advantage here. Sensible option from Ruan Pienaar. Man just come on the field. Didn't command that high ball at all, Sika. And also again making huge amount of grounds by using the old Gary Owen.
You wonder as well whether Ulster are actually just benefiting slightly from having a Welsh referee, you know, an English-speaking referee. Just that split second of translation just gives you that little moment to react a little bit more quickly.
Anthony Flossman taken off. Missed the penalty early on, and Jonathan Felice got one, and then also responded with that Trimble try, didn't they? Kind of Jackson conversion. They've missed three penalties since, but it's still 7 points to 3 to the Irish province. Here's Tommy Bowe, Jared Payne, Trimble. He's really got one. 50 caps. He won in the summer. Tried scoring 50th cap appearance against Canada. Jackson into Wilson. Northampton, of course, Roger Wilson, man of the match against Leicester.
And look, Pienaar spotted there was nobody at home if that ball had just managed to get over the top. No defender at all.
Taking it. Back into the 22, Sikar. It's come off Ulster. Rob of the Green, definitely with Ulster in this first 40 minutes, but some would say you make your own luck. Johan Muller. As far as Ulster are concerned, they could nick another 3 points before half-time, about 7 or so minutes away. Take it out to 10-3. Very happy with the first 40 as Payne races back.
Yeah, Ulster will be absolutely delighted with the way this match has started. You've got to give great credit to the pack. The scrums have been really competitive. I mean, after the first half last week against Tigers, where they were under a huge amount of pressure, gave a few penalties away, they've really addressed that this week. Started off very strongly, and at the ruck, very competitive. The back row worked very hard. Muller, Tui, very strong as well.
Uvalde to big Jim Hamilton, 6'8" of the Scotland international, going through the Leicester Academy, didn't he? Home to Edinburgh, Gloucester captain. Multiple appearances in the Aviva Premiership for Gloucester. Jim Hamilton, there's two mauls going on here.
Use it!
To me, say, it's there for him now. Drago. The Trandu, those two old friends, schooled here in Montpellier together. Nagusa, his possession away. Trimble. Just see what Trimble was trying to do. Saw space. Pienaar, it's not gone too far, this one. Felice comes up with one of the shortest men on the field.
Plenty of space out right here.
Tranduc, Combezou, Sika. Advantage coming to Montpellier. Definitely rocked in the first half an hour here in Montpellier, especially with that Andrew Trimble try. Tranduc, drop goal. Gone wide. Well wide.
22,
again, that sends out a really big message to Ulster when you're having an international fly half snapping at drop goals. Rana just keeping the ball in hands, putting more pressure for the first time in this game. Real momentum coming from the Montpellier side.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, East.
The Ulster defensive line, one or two moments, slightly rocked, here, but Montpellier unable to get that offload away. A couple of very aggressive lines being hit here. An offload, a quick ball. All of a sudden there's space on, but Ulster managed to reset. Crowd very unhappy about the body check.
Funny that. Well, if Ulster can keep this to 7-3 at half time, just a couple of minutes left now. Duke has knocked it on.
Back off white. First back off white, then a knock on black.
And backwards from Ulster hand.
And knocked back by white, then knocked on by black.
Then Montpellier. And also really just want to see this first half out now, don't they?
Because this is your side.
Yeah, you're deep in your own half. You're looking at the clock. You want to get out. You want to get into that changing room. You want to sit down. Just take stock. Give yourself a bit of a pat on the back. Get the water on board and talk about what you're going to do in the second half. Ulster will be delighted if they can go in at halftime with a scoreline. And arguably, it should have been more because they've had a couple of penalty opportunities that normally you'd expect both Tinar and Jackson to be able to convert.
And his point worth making is that Montpellier, their outside backs, both their outside backs are on already, Sikar and Kombezu. Plenty of scrum half on the bench. You have Tally Watchu and Nicolas Mas. Of course, the Perpignan stalwart on the bench. But also haven't used their bench at all. John Afoa to come on. Lewis Stevens, another really good line out operator. Ian Henderson, Paul Marshall. Very nippy scrum half. Stuart Holding. Mike Allen as well, on the joint top scorer in the Pro 12 this season. Things are looking rosy for Ulster, but if you've watched any sort of Heineken Cup rugby in the past, you know.
You know that Montpellier will have their time in this game.
There are twists and turns in this competition like no other.
Yes, nice.
Penalty to Ulster. Call may well have come from the assistant referee on the far side, Tom Corp, getting the plaudits from his pack around him. And that is it. That is half-time. And Ulster do hold on to that lead. They've left 9 points out there with the three missed penalties, but they have got that crucial try from Andrew Trimble. It is Ulster 7, Montpellier 3 here at half-time at the Stade Yves de Manoir.
Continuity is agility. Hamlin sponsors Rugby Union on Sky Sports. People having ships for sea.
Both sets of players still inside the bowels of the stadium, getting their halftime instructions. Ulster, of course, Mark Anscombe is a huge fan of this Heineken Cup, says that Southern Hemisphere players come to the North because of the Heineken Cup and the prestige it has. Players can pit themselves against the best the Northern Hemisphere has. And in his words, playing on a big stage in Europe challenges us to be able to handle pressure, to sustain pressure, to work as hard as individuals and work for each other, to challenge each other, to be honest in each other's performance, and just to keep going for 80 minutes when you've got absolutely nothing left. That epitomises this game, and that is what this competition requires of us. And that is exactly what his side is doing at the moment in the first 40 minutes here at the Stade Yves du Manoir.
Yeah, they'll be delighted, and Mark Anscombe will be delighted. We've got to say, mind you, that Montpellier have been exceptionally poor, given that this is their home pitch. There's such expectation of them in this competition. They really fancy their chances, and Mario Ledesma will have given those boys a real roasting at halftime. You expect now Odrago, Gorgodza, Priva, Jim Hamill to try and get Trinduk and Palisse on the front foot, give them some go-forward ball, and try and unleash the undoubted talent that is in this back line. But Ulster, really, it's just a case of more of the same. Expect Pienaar Jackson to put this ball in there. Interesting, we can see John Afoa warming up in the dead ball area. He's going to come off the bench. Oling will come on. Henderson will come on. Big, big test. There's so much more rugby to go in this contest. But certainly, Montpellier with lots to prove. And Ulster, well, they've got 40 minutes from what would be an exceptional result here. But 40 minutes is a long time in a rugby game.
It certainly is. 7-3, Ulster lead. And if anything, they went slightly behind them. It is swirling down here in this magnificent stadium as fans make their way back to their seats. A glass of red wine or a beer at half time, such is the way here in France. But Ulster tactically so assured in that first half, that such a young back line. You look at the likes of Paddy Jackson, Luke Marshall, Tommy Rowe, one of the elder statesmen, wearing 11, but definitely playing on the right wing.
Starting the second half in good shape, just prodding the ball through there. Setting up camp, asking a few questions again at this Montpellier side.
We do expect a reaction from Montpellier. Very poor in that first half. Trimble. Ball ripped off him from his old pal, Nagusa, Tomoki Nagusa. Gogodzi was there as well. Tua Tuvaki now for the pass from Trandu. Sika, Jan Odrin. Crowd beginning to find their voice. Votrimen now. One cap for France against Argentina last summer. That's better from Montpellier.
It's just a pilot.
Well, and the expectation that Andrew Trimble had actually got that ball, the Ulster pack very much went in to help him out, and instead Gorgodza getting the ball back, placing it all of a sudden. There was huge space, defensive line all over the place. So Ulster living off their wits, and really just having to scramble. But they work hard for each other.
Time is off for a second.
Tom Court doing a great job slowing the ball, the ruck there.
Let's get these scrums better in the second half, okay?
Just need the four else to Rory Best.
The closely lined better.
Heineken Cup appearances to his name. 44 in all. His 45th appearance today. 44th start. Tells you something about the importance of Rory Best to this Ulster side. Those horrific neck injuries a few years ago now, an entire season out.
We call the crouch, let's just get into that crouch position a little quicker for you, okay?
Involved in two finals in the last 2 years, Rory Best. Started both the Heineken Cup final 2 years ago. And of course, the Pro 12 final last year. Fabien Galthié looks on.
Bind.
Wonderful player he was. And
set! Yes, nine.
Turning into a pretty good coach, isn't he? Some choice words, I would have thought, at half time. It's Galthié. His name set, picks up from the base of the scrum. Odra. Godzi. The link man. The open side. Pellissa. Jim Hamilton. Ball just squirts out. Jared Payne doesn't just kick the ball away.
Over.
Puts his head up. Looks to see what's in front of him. And it's Benoit Sika. Pass away, he's there, but Rory Best and Jared Payne gets in on the ball. Looking to hold this ball up, and if they do, it would be an Ulster put into the scrum. What's the call here? It is a maul. It is Ulster with a put in. Every part of their game is really working out for Ulster at the moment.
The tempo has gone up ever so slightly, a lot more urgency to the ball carrying the Montpellier side. Trying to get through that aggressive Ulster defence with the inside ball from Tindouk.
Ulster lead. No score clock for the host broadcaster.
Crouch! Bind! Set!
Lights are on here in Montpellier. Two front rows jostling. Of course, the scrum half has to wait till the referee's happy that both front rows, both packs are stable and steady before he gives the call to the scrum half. Then the scrum half to put the ball in.
The hallmark of Ulster's success in the opening 40 minutes was that solid, solid scrum. I suppose Ulster hoped that they could get parity at the set piece, but actually as the match has gone on, increasingly, you can see Diak pointing it out, the front row creaking on the Montpellier side, increasingly Ulster growing and strengthening. Of course, let's not forget Jonathan Foa to potentially take the pitch at some stage.
Tom Cord, excellent work. There'll be an admission that he's not the best tactical scrummager, the best technique in the front row, but he's such a strong man. He's an Olympic trialist for shot put in Australia, where he grew up, Brisbane. Ruan Pienaar missed two in the first half. Paddy Jackson missed one. Can't afford to miss too many more. Doesn't miss that one. Just snicked over the crossbar, didn't it? To the delight of the big travelling contingent here for Ulster.
Number one change.
10 points to three.
Wait.
When the kickers were out for the game, actually that was the end that both Paddy Jackson and Ruan Pienaar were practicing at, and they didn't miss a kick, certainly in the 10-15 minutes that we were watching. So maybe more comfortable actually with the dimensions of this half of the pitch. They're getting a feel in the warm-up. Certainly Pienaar, he knows his distance. Anything on the halfway line, he's going to be absolutely lethal.
Liashvili, Georgian internationals on in the front row. A couple of minutes into the second half. On the loose head side, there he is, wearing 17. Seven caps for Georgia. Looking to work something on the short side with Priva. There is a huge pocket of Ulster supporters to our right-hand side. The familiar song of Stand Up For The Ulstermen ringing out around the stadium. Tally Watchu is on. So fresh legs in that front five for Montpellier.
Crouch! Bind! Set!
Yes, nine?
Good flick up from Wilson to Pienaar. I would have been under pressure if he'd been at the base of the scrum. Jared Payne just slices it through for Trimble. Sika, good run from him, looks inside. Into Convezu, Pelisse, Rowan Drago. This is more the style of rugby that Montpellier have been playing all season and found themselves right at the top of the top 14. Kellen Galtier, the number eight. Pelisse again. Convezu. Yashvili with Godzik. Bustos using the big men to truck it up in the middle. Into Varki, Nagusan out, into Trimble. Jared Payne is there as well. Ulster's defence holding out at the moment. They are taking on water here. Tally Watchu up against Johan Muller. Bustos again.
Five!
Involved a couple of times in this move. The tie heads. Crowd find the volume switch. Gogodzic, so strong, just holding up the ball. But in the end, he dropped it and it's knocked forward. And all that pressure comes to nothing. And the crowd whistling and booing now their team. Such is the way in France.
Well, that knock on from Gogodzic. Like a get out of jail card, but this is why it happened. Andrew Trimble's missed tackle just shows you one missed tackle in that chasing line, and all of a sudden it just seems as if this French side increases in numbers, players all over the place, comfortable on the ball, but it all came that chasing line after Jared Taines a stab through with the ball.
The Jonifer does come on. The All Black. Calf injury behind him now.
Close and high.
Nicola Mass is on as well.
Well, he's quite literally two heavyweights entering the fray. But when you're playing against these French sides and suddenly things turn and there's a little bit of space, it just feels as if they just swamp you. Players, angles, offloads, and just you're chasing shadows. You've got to keep structure in the game. You've got to keep control.
And also play the structured and nature of a very definite game plan now. First 40 minutes, you want to stick to that and see when it breaks up just how dangerous Montpellier are. John Furr is uprooted in that first scrum, the arm is out for the referee, but Montpellier want more here. Couple of metres shy of the line now, Gogodzic. Furr is having to do some heavy duty defensive work. There's numbers out there. Now have Montpellier scored. They did their best not to, didn't they? Assistant referee thinks the ball was knocked forward. We are going to Gareth Simmons, the television match official.
Can you tell me if it's a try, yes or no? And can you just look at the pass prior to any possible try, please?
Of course, now.
Playing advantage from this scrum, though, OK?
Television match official can come in, can be asked the question by the referee and adjudicate on these kind of moments. That pass from Trandu.
Well, that looks as if it's gone backwards. I've got to say, from this angle, this is not the angle that's going to show it either. He just worked his way inside. Is that right boot in touch as well? Before the ball goes down, you see the scuff mark.
It's Jan Odrin, isn't it? That angle's not going to show it, but my eye was immediately drawn to his boot. Of course, we are playing advantage from the scrum, so at very least, Montpellier will have a penalty here.
Well, this is going to show us a little bit more.
Are you still checking?
Yes.
That's gone backwards.
There.
Ooh, does it show you the foot?
To be the wider angle. That's checked the forward pass. It's not a forward pass. Does that boot go into touch? You would see from this angle. Big moment here, isn't it?
And just it's that white boot, I think. That pass is at worst lateral. The crowd have really found their voice
Lincoln,
now.
Can you hear me?
Yeah,
here's a decision.
Well, you've got a decision.
Yes, the decision is the grounding is good and there's nothing clear and obvious on a forward pass.
Okay, I agree. So it's a try.
Agreed.
The try has been given. Montpellier demanded a response to themselves. Mario Ledesma demanded a response at the start of the second half. That's exactly what his players have given him.
And what an introduction for John Afoa in the scrum. And when the French get into that sort of position, it feels irresistible. And every indication was that Montpellier were going to come away with some sort of points there. But again, you bring it back to that one missed tackle in the chasing line.
What do you say? You can tell from his reaction that he wasn't able to add the 2 points. This conversion from the scrum half. Ulster still have the lead, but by just 2 points now.
Already there's a big question mark now being posed by this Montpellier side. Little test of character coming up in the next 5 minutes for the Ulster players.
We have the ball back though. Pienaar finds Payne. So often does that, doesn't he? Comes back from where the pass been given. The tails are up for the men. And yellow and black. Jackson finds Trimble. And Tally Watcher as well. Jackson almost scrum half-like. Puts the ball down into that corner. Nagusa. Felice doesn't have much time.
That was a beautiful kick from Paddy Jackson. Waited absolutely perfectly. Rolling end over end, but just stopping short right in the corner. Gives no angle at all. Get that kick cleared.
Time off, substitution. 12 white. Number 12 white change.
Marshall is coming off now. 50-minute mark. Stuart Olding will be the man to replace, and there he is. The 20-year-old. Right through the academy. He was captain the summer against the United States of America. Ivaldi. Also got to weather this storm the next 5 or so minutes. It's heavy clouds.
Over
the Stade Yves de Manoir. Advantage coming to the home side. Go Godzilla. Wonderful game.
Isn't advantage it? Over.
First Heineken Cup game against Leicester 2 seasons ago.
Ball is there.
16 all draw. Well read by Darren Cave. Since the Nagusa. Go back again. Not known for his kicking, is he? Timoki Nagusa. Darren Cave, that's a good chase from him. Tried to stay on his feet, and he did, and he's won the penalty.
Again, it was just the execution of the kick. Just put Nagusa under all sorts of pressure. Not a natural kicker,
squeeze
an instinctive counter-attacker,
the body,
but there were enough white shirts there just to affect the turnover. Cave following up his kick. See that left arm just clasped over the ball. And this blustery wind actually does blow right down into that corner. Ulster have been wanting to play most of the rugby down in this half, down in that corner.
This is a real test, isn't it?
It's strange for all the collisions and runs in that first half. Now you feel as if we've got a match on our hands. They were slightly sparring with each other in that first half. Now the match has really taken off.
Montpellier were just not themselves. That's happened in the Heineken Cup. Look at that first round, the likes of Harlequins and Glasgow in the first half, just not themselves. Same can be said of Montpellier here in this first half, but they responded with that early try. From Jan Odrin. Now it's Rampino. Excellent penalty work from Darren Cave, chasing his own kick. Rampino shouldn't miss that, and does it. Fabien Galtier, yep. Throwing the headphones down at the moment, but he's taking them off.
And there'll be an added little bit of spice between Trimble and Nagusa. They were Ulster colleagues not so long ago. Nagusa wore the white of Ulster before coming to the south of France.
He scored 3 tries in his 4 Heineken Cup appearances for Ulster. Smoky Nagusa. Ian Henderson. On for Robbie Dier. He is a man now to run past us in the tunnel before the game. Huge beast of a man.
Release!
A very bright future ahead of Ian Henderson. Already 6 caps to his name.
Use it!
In his debut against South Africa. 2012 Autumn Series. Tina. Another played second fiddle, didn't he, to Furu Dupree in the Rugby Championship. He's knocked on from Ruin Tina. I did the first bit really, really well.
Forward.
Took the high ball under huge amounts of pressure. And there is a hand in there or not, but knocked the ball on, and Montpellier will have the scrum. Frenetic start to this second half.
Well, there had to be a response from Montpellier. You know, we expected it. I think probably Ulster expected it.
Step up.
But you see Ian Henderson, Stuart Olding. Come on, Henderson. Do not be deceived by the baby face. Big ball carrier, big offensive hitter in the tackle. Gets across the gain line.
Crouch!
But also we're really pleased, David Humphreys.
Bynes!
With that ruined Pienaar penalty after the Montpellier try. going to go down step to the wire, of course.
Ulster.
Back to that games in round three and four against Benetton Treviso. Home first. Treviso, very difficult nut to crack. Quite the team they were, not quite the strength and depth.
Bind. Set. Yes, nine.
They'll be looking for at least eight, if not 9, 10 points in those games. And then we'll have Montpellier back at home. Chris Henry's done great work. Stuart Holding. Now Darren Kay. Space is there. Paddy Jackson will cut back inside. Henderson is there. It's on the ground, but the referee's happy to play on. Henderson needs to roll back the way of Olsen out. Do well to get this ball back. They do. Henry, Wilson, Bowe knows there's space out there. Payne, lovely dummy. It's Tom Court. Looks inside. Finds Tranduc. Now he races away. That was a golden opportunity for Ulster. They left opportunities out on the field against Leicester. They came through that.
Great tackle and great control from Chris Henry. And here it's just about keeping cool. I mean, Court did well with the ball in hand, but he just wanted somebody else other than a number one, two or three over in that part of the pitch. Tried manfully to get the offload away.
Number four.
I mean, a second row would have reached over from the line for there. Tom Court's not a small man at 6'3", but Jim Hamilton may well have stretched out a telescopic arm to score it. His evening is done. Friva is back on. Not sure whether that's a blood substitution or not. Friva coming back on.
Again, just shows how dangerous this three-quarter line can be. And you saw the ball handling of Henry, of Roger Wilson. Very intelligent back row.
What I like about it, it's heads-up rugby, isn't it? Playing what's in front of them.
Very calm again from Jared Payne. Just held the ball up, went through the gap. Simple two-on-one, but the defenders arrived in time.
Now it's the forwards that are driving more. Rory Best is there. Chris Henry feels that space over the ball. So importantly, Wilson is knocked back. Nicola Mass. Pino says to Muller, take it on. Drago, great tackle from him, the captain, leading by example. Henderson already heavily involved since he's come on.
Foul.
Well, God's it. Smash the Spoa to the ground, but he was offside. Yep. Advantage is being played. Henderson going up the touchline. Wilson knew the penalty was coming.
Yeah.
Godzilla, too keen to make the big hit.
Seven.
Big ball carry from Ian Henderson. But really smart play from Ulster, playing short side rugby, bringing it infield, one phase, back where they've got numbers on the short side, just maintaining possession, going through the phases. See the short side, big ball carry from Henderson. One, two. Gets that ball back. And if it hadn't been for Gorgodze, it could have been for Nicola Mass coming back offside.
Take the Ulster hat off for a moment.
That's right.
The arm was out from the referee. They were playing advantage, and now Ruan Pienaar to take it out to 16 points to 8. This would require Montpellier to score twice. Pienaar is not going to miss from there.
I said there was a little test of character for the Ulster players after Montpellier had scored that try. And really have come back, played rugby in that Montpellier half, taking chances.
And tactically, so good Ulster.
All right.
Kicking game has been exceptional. Their chase game has been exceptional.
Yeah.
And just when Montpellier getting their tails up, they
leave him go
to the mall. Andy Jackson under this one. Montpellier. And Tran Duke.
Advantage black.
Advantage coming to Montpellier here. They know they're in a real fight here. But Godsey knows it.
Advantage over.
Little kick. Tran Duke is chasing. Tommy Vaux. 22. Alert as ever. Plan call, well worked from the halfbacks.
Well, I'll take the Ulster hat off. Dan Toohey needed to get down onto that ball. Bending over, trying to get it in two hands. Get the body on the ground. Get the ball, secure it. Tommy Vaux did well. Sensed there was nobody at home.
Into the last quarter of this game. Two scores away, Ulster up. Sika.
Play on, no, we've both gone up for it.
Can't take it. Kompezou. Can't make the tackle. Stuart Oldie can't make the tackle. Kompezou. Deep into the Ulster 22. Pellice, the ball is there for it. Tally Watchu, Ulster just beginning to drop off the tackles. But Godsey, has that gone forwards? No, says the referee.
Off your feet, White.
Tran Duke, the step, the double step. Pellice again, Henderson is there to meet him and repel him. Building for Montpellier here. Nicolas Mas tries to start up the rolling maul. Drago. Four. Godzi. Needs support now though. Squirts out on the Ulster side. And Dan Toohey is there again. Great defensive work. Olding just thought for a moment he might try and run the ball. That's a fine, fine kick for the young man. Ulster. Out of jail again.
Did if Montpellier had recycled the ball slightly quicker, there were men on, there was plenty of space. But Dan Toohey, well, got his hands on the ball on that occasion. And a great run then from Kompezou. Getting past Payne and Olding.
Time off, substitution.
But a terrific clearance kick from Olding off the left peg.
Two black.
For Godza again, the hands letting him down close to the line. Ernie Cup Rugby, Mario Ledesma said in the papers today, it goes up a level. And because of that, you've got to take your chances. It's twice now, Godza is knocked on with the line beckoning.
Do you remember that Tommy Vaux pass at Raven Hill last week against Leicester? They got away with it in round one. You can't afford to get away with it for too long. You ride your luck in this competition, of course, but luck is not going to take you all the way to the final, which is exactly where Ulster want to be back at. It's Montpellier leaving the chances out there at the moment. Of course, 9 points Ulster left out there in the first half.
Step off here.
For God's sake, his afternoon's work is done. Gracie is on, as is Bianchi, the hooker.
Release White!
Pellice. Tuatavaki. Haven't seen too much of him. Compliment to Ulster's defence.
Again, nobody in the ruck there by Ulster. Making sure they get their defensive line set.
So it's really their game to lose now. That is a huge up and under from Tran Duke.
Play on.
So many hands up there, came off a black hand, so John O'Farr is allowed to play on. Dan Toohey, it's an excellent leg drive from the big second row. Pienaar looked up, saw acres and acres of space, needs to get the kick right though. Tran Duke, a little slip
black
from him.
Stand.
But again, it's such intelligent rugby from Ruan Pienaar. John O'Farr as well, those experienced players for Ulster standing up when it matters most.
Well, so many hands around the ball there. Came back off to Tavake. Lovely offload from a forward to Dan Toohey. And again, just Tinar's kick just slightly takes the pressure off.
The line.
David Humphries has been feeling quite happy with that kick.
Step onto the line, please.
Just to the line out. Right to the halfway line, gives them possession. And all the time, that clock is ticking away. Two scores away, of course, Montpellier.
Use it! No hands, Black!
Only lost once in the last 18 games in all competitions here at home, Montpellier.
Backwards off Black, play on.
Again, they can't take the high ball.
Use it, Black!
For them, of course, Leicester in rounds 3 and 4. First away at Welford Road, and then back here. The Heineken Cup takes a break. To top 14 duty. Sean Duke has to go on the weaker left boot.
Grip pressure. Forced to get it out as quickly as possible. But again, that high ball coming back to haunt the Montpellier back three. Oudrin, not a big guy. When you've got a 6'3" Tommy Bow bearing down at you, terrific aerial skills.
The police say it's going up.
Middle.
Deus. Replacement. Second spell at Montpellier. All the replacements used for Montpellier now.
Well, Pellissé was the form selection, but hasn't just quite had the platform from his pack.
Johan Muller couldn't take the line out.
Don't block seven.
Tommy Bow. Wonderful try, wasn't it? Ravenhill last week. It's been turned over to a Tavaki.
Vantage over.
Crowd think Lammers tripped up as he ran through. Now Oslo will do well here to take the ball room. Pienaar, a better man in that situation, just to calm things down. To get it off the field, crowd incensed by referee Leighton Hodges, and almost as a reaction to the crowd's reaction, he's going to the television match official to see if there was foul play.
Yes, Leighton.
Okay, can you just review whether there's
any
obstruction
from that angle?
It's all caused really aggressive counter rocking from the Montpellier pack. Well, you know, if I was a Montpellier player, I would be saying that Bowling had not made enough of an effort to get away from the ball. He's coming in to try and make that tackle. Is it just after? These are the decisions that games can turn on or that can give lifelines to teams.
And if you're an Ulster player, you say, well, he doesn't need to get out of the way. That's
you're not
saying wrong.
You say he's coming in, he's committing himself.
Of course, the referee looking at it on the big screen here. To make their own decision from what they see as well. Stuart Holding.
Leighton, are you happy to make a decision on that?
Yeah, I'm happy. There's nothing in that for me.
I agree, Leighton.
Nothing clear and obvious.
I agree.
Okay, just the line out. Nothing.
Just the line out is the decision from Leighton Hodges, who made his own decision. And Griffiths should always make their own decision if they can. And Leighton Hodges saw it on the big screen. Stuart Holding doesn't have to make an attempt. It's very difficult at that kind of pace to step away, but
and now they're saying well done Stuart Holding.
They are indeed. Right for the referee to say
more?
Probably the bang from the crowd influences decision to go to the television match official. But here
when
come
stop,
Montpellier
stop.
Driving more has stopped once, but it goes on again. Also have done well to get it on the floor. Kelly watching. Also not committing anyone to that breakdown at all. Just slips. Possession still there for Montpellier. They score here. What a grandstand finish we have. Yes, again. Rory Best not for the first time in this game, doing brilliant work
there, lads. Black ball
in the tackle.
Look, Blacker in possession, neither side are going forward.
Rory Best
just an unplayable.
Will not believe that because once again he did so well getting in on the ball. Big steal there, he's on his feet and he's taken out then by a Montpellier player.
Just gonna check that he wasn't dangerously cleaned out at the ruck. Around about here.
A bit further on, number 8, Black 18. Unsure if it was accidental, but just check.
Black 18, you
Black
think?
Black 18.
Okay. So time is off.
Referees come in, time is off.
Simo.
And go back to the television match.
Okay, so
some foul play or suspected foul play.
Just after the maul, where the maul went to ground. Can you just check if there was any illegality in the clean out after that, please, by 18 Black?
Okay, checking 18 Black.
The difficulty with the clean out is that Rory Best is so well placed over the ball, he's impossible to actually ruck out of it in a straightforward fashion. So you've almost got to flip him like a wrestler. And I think, you know, they're saying, was he taken out illegally there? They're looking at Black 18.
Look at the ruck before, aren't we?
They're looking at Nicola Mass, I think, there.
Quitter is the man just before Nicola Mass to try and take Dan Toohey out of the way.
Well, certainly it's the whether the use of the head.
Sorry, Tony, it's just that far side. I don't think there's anything in that.
No, it's
not tiddlywinks, is it? Let's be honest.
No, it hasn't been aimed at a particular part of the body.
Gareth, have we seen all the angles? Okay.
Just asking for the one more.
Okay.
This is what the union after all. It's on the far side. Nicola Mass and Quercy is he led with a head? Maybe this is the angle, isn't it?
Okay, Leighton, you happy on that?
Yeah, we've seen all the angles there, Simo, have we?
Now this, that clear out. It's accidental.
I don't think there's anything in that. I don't think the players would have any issue with that.
Okay, I've seen enough.
Yeah.
There's no intent.
Okay, there's nothing in that for me. I'm just going to go with a scrum for the unplayable where we were back
yes,
there.
Yes, I agree. Nothing clear and obvious.
Okay.
What this is doing, mind you,
it's
sucking momentum out of the Montpellier side. You know, they're getting on a roll, but these stoppages, just press pause,
allow Ulster to just
organise
themselves. So it's an unplayable scrum here.
It's unplayable, said the referee, but it's all worth noting. The television match official, clear and obvious.
Just unplayable scrum.
And that's another part of the new protocols of television match official. Only if it's clear and obvious can they make a decision on it.
It's also great for the referee to have the big screen in the corner to actually see it for himself as well.
You don't want to see the day when referees don't make decisions themselves as they could do. And it's head on head for Montpellier, and Ulster have the penalty. Tell you what, you cannot believe it.
Need you closer.
Neither can the crowd, and this game is very much slipping away from Montpellier. And this home record, never lost in this competition. This is their third season.
The second time.
But they won 18 of the last 21 home games. Unbeaten in the last 11 European fixtures here at home since Connacht. 2009, the only Irish side to have visited this stade at Youth du Manoir. And Ulster will take the penalty, take the line out, take their time. European are yet again this afternoon will put the high ball up. They know Nagusa, don't they? They know his strengths and weaknesses, and they peppered the Fijian winger all afternoon with those high kicks. In fact, the entirety of the Montpellier back three, and is a tactic that has worked so well for Ulster.
Nagusa is a heck of an attacking winger, but Ulster know that he is susceptible under that high ball. Pienaar has just tortured him all afternoon.
Here's you, some way finding a way out of defence. Jared Payne runs it straight back. And this is where Ulster want to be playing the last 11 or so minutes. Paddy Jackson. I haven't seen a huge amount of him in the second 40, but it's been a forward-orientated second half. Here's Wilson. Darren Cave looking for that offload. So often does, doesn't it? Another penalty to Ulster. And Drago is penalised.
Stop the policeman.
He can't quite believe it. Players protesting. Odra giving his tuppence worth to the referee. You hear from the crowd what they make of the decision. Tackle has to roll away.
It's two big decisions from the referee. One allowed Ulster to clear their lines and now allowed them to get into a position where Montpellier have to score two tries. And that just, you know, it means Montpellier seriously have to chase the game in this last 10 minutes.
But Ruantino has to get this kick first. Three penalties in the 2012 final. Not quite as important as those kicks. But it's right up there, isn't it? This to make it an incredible final 10 minutes here in Montpellier. The crowd whistling and booing Ruan Pienaar, but he shuts it all out and adds three more.
Well, with 10 minutes to go, this is made for cool heads. It doesn't come any more cool than Ruan Pienaar. You wouldn't want anybody else behind that kick. 19-8, that is a serious cushion now.
Can they protect it all while Ulster continue to play?
Nobody touched.
Callum Black on for Tom Court. Another good afternoon from Tom Court.
Hands are on.
Still four players left on the
Ulster
bench.
Over.
None for Montpellier. Sika, this young fly half playing at fullback when Anthony Flosser has given the shepherd's crook, wasn't he? 25 minutes into the game. Boshin. Gantier, the number eight, has been turned over by Henderson, is it? Was for a moment. Nagusa. Robbins Taliwachu.
Off your feet.
In the tire of saying that.
Leave moment. It go.
Tran Duke. Tuna Tuvake. Good ball presentation for the scrum half. Big hit from Dan Toohey.
Banshee.
To Sika. Oprah. I'd like to have the likes of Rooney Ranger on the bench now. Hey, how's you? Stay. Tell me, watch you. Pashin found a way through the middle. Montpellier coming here wave after wave. Galtier's missed out. Tranduc. Surely a try now. It's been left. And it's Trimble racing away. Been kicked ahead by Ruan Pienaar now. Who has the pace? Kompazou does.
Ball's out.
But again, Ulster find themselves deep in Montpellier half. And Henderson has turned this ball over. It's loose and free now, Trimble. You could sense the frustration around this ground as Ulster awarded another penalty. The crowd around us stamping their feet in frustration.
This is crazy rugby. Extraordinary scramble defence. Great breaks from Montpellier. They've come straight back at Ulster.
Somebody else is going to have to kick. Post.
You would have staked anything that this ball had gone. Look at that tackle. The ball is just dropped.
He doesn't need to kick, kick, but the minute starts now, okay?
What a tackle from Paddy Jackson. Absolutely scythes him down.
And then Trimble. Party mouth time, but Tino was able to get on the end of it. Henderson, what an impact he's had since he's come in the second half. The minute is ticking for Ruan Pienaar. Receives some attention, but this is directly in front of the post, and this surely is the final nail in the coffin for Ulster. And what will be, unless a rugby miracle happens, a famous, famous victory for the Ulsterman. Needs to calm himself. It's a fair distance, but it's right in front of the post. No mistake from the Springbok. 22 points to 8.
Fine margins at this level of the Heineken Cup. Instead of 7 points, clawing Montpellier back into the game.
And 14.
Instead, that door not only slams, but Ruan Pienaar, I think, has very much turned the key and locked that door for Montpellier.
He is going off.
Number 14.
Trimble is going 14. Off. Rory Best is going 14. Off. The final fresh legs. And can he work from Ulster? Rory Best puffs the cheeks out. Good afternoon's work from him. He will know the significance of this victory. Mike Allen comes on. Trimble off.
There's still almost 7 minutes to go. I mean, Montpellier, like any French side, capable of brilliance, but from this size of a lead, you just cannot see, with the control that Ulster have had, you cannot see Montpellier coming up with something.
I mean, they don't have the big bucks. There's Bo. Ulster want more here. Line out in the 22. I was just about to say, Montpellier don't have the huge amounts of money the likes of Racing and Toulon. It's always going to be a question whether it'll be a focus on one tournament or the other, not the resources to challenge on both. And I think we're possibly seeing that here this afternoon.
Really interesting from an Ulster point of view. These last two games, last week against the Tigers and again against Montpellier, the high ball has been a major difference between the sides.
Leon, one by Black. Rudra, the wheel comes in.
Don't block.
Need to go for it now, don't they? Montpellier, accuracy wasn't there in Italy last week. Accuracy certainly hasn't been here today at their home ground. Marshall, Paul Marshall, the replacement scrum half, into the replacement loose head, Callum Black. The front row of Ornin. The state area, Dan Tui has a fine game, isn't he? Jackson. Here's Mike Allen now, holding. Ball bobbling around. Can't take it. They won't mind too much. Another set scrum, another minute gone on the clock.
Talking to supporters last night, I think the best that they hoped for was a losing bonus point here. Not sure how realistic their hopes were of getting a win. Nick Williams injured, that, you know, size, colossal size away from the back row.
Number four, White.
Ulster needed something from this game, with Leicester Tigers getting a losing bonus point last week. Ulster needed to get something, but what self-belief, what control, and what quality rugby from Ulster. This pack has been magnificent this afternoon.
Time back on.
Poor man in particular, Johan Muller, makes way for Lewis Stevenson.
Nice and close.
Leicester picked up the bonus point against Treviso last night in the final play of the game, so 5 points to Leicester. And they are the next opponents for Montpellier, aren't they, at Welford Road in December. Whereas Ulster home tie against Treviso. You have to say, Ulster, long way to go in this pool, of course. You have to visit Welford Road in round six. But this away victory is so hard to come by in the Heineken Cup, so hard to come by in France. Especially this kind of arena. They will have. Stepped in the driving seat right in this pool.
It makes it so interesting. Tigers have done very well getting that bonus point, and the bonus point then last night against Treviso. Ulster now have got that vital away win. Treviso, who knows, could provide a shock somewhere in this competition. Really, the banana skin for all of these sides. Montpellier having lost at home, if this stays the way it is, the pressure is on them to come up with something when they go to Welford Road.
Treviso certainly not going to come out of this pool, are they? But may well have an effect on it. Chris Henry, it's coughed up again for Montpellier. A weeks-long catching practice, I would have thought, for Montpellier in the week. Moving into the next top 14 game. It's Bayonne away from home, Grenoble and Castres home. Rushing Metro away, and then into those games against Leicester. It doesn't get any easier, does it? But this is an incredible home record. You mustn't shy away from this. And therefore, it makes Ulster's performance a bit better, a bit more special. And Drago, tackled by Cave, manages to get the offload away to Galtier Nagusa. It's been negated, hasn't it? He's an attacking force. It's been a weakness, really.
Knock on black.
Peyush knocks the ball on the replacement scrum half.
He's knocked it on the floor.
I finally pronounced his name right.
It's what makes this competition so, so good. You know, for all of us, you know, we can just now go on the what-ifs of round three and round four. You look ahead, you look at the points difference at this stage after only two games for the players. Well, they've just got to focus on next week. They have just got to go back to work come Monday morning for the rest of us. We can enjoy now. So we're talking rubbish and discussing about what's going to happen in the next couple of games.
I have to say, walking around the stadium in Montpellier last night, real buzz that the Ulster fans have brought with them. Absolute beauty of the Heineken Cup.
Binds.
Just do everything to keep this pan-European competition that attracts the likes of Ruud Pienaar to the Northern Hemisphere. And what an influence the South African has had on this afternoon's proceedings. Jackson. As they did so well in the first half and continued in the second half, just pushing Montpellier back into their own 22, going for the corner, and Paddy Jackson, like Ruud Pienaar, has kicked exceptionally today.
His kicking last week was absolute precision, and what you've had right throughout this game from Paddy Jackson has been absolute quality with the boot, but that tackle under the post was fabulous and really, really just reinforced this Ulster victory.
Ulster got a hand in there. It was Toohey, I think, Marshall trying to dig that ball out. It's a penalty to Ulster.
17.
Do you think Fabien Galtier is going to have words about the referee afterwards? Galtier and Ledesma will be going mad, but Ulster have been on the front foot for most of the game. You invariably get the way that the referee gives his decisions.
I mean, this
and
is
off his feet.
He is off his feet. There's
no doubt about that. He's absolutely 100% right in that decision.
That is the letter of the law. You could come back to Leighton Hodges, in my humble opinion, influenced by the crowd when they were down here on the 22. So it swings and roundabouts. You can't blame the referee.
From our position, arguably Ulster have had the rub of the green in some of those tiny 50-50 decisions, but nonetheless they've played themselves into that position. Technically they've been better at the breakdown. We wondered with Nick Williams off the pitch, but Diak, Wilson, Henderson, Henry have all been really effective.
There's Fabien Galtier, back to the drawing board for him. Reached the quarterfinals, lost to Clermont last season. Looks unlikely now, must win your home games. And Paddy Jackson rounds things up. Superb kicking game for Ulster here. European now, so the highest quality. The tactics were absolutely spot on for Ulster today.
It was a magnificent performance from Ulster. You cannot underestimate how difficult it is coming to the home pitch of a French heavyweight and coming away with the spoils. Yes, they got the rub of the green. Yes, Montpellier underperformed, but Ulster made their own luck over the course of 80 minutes. They took their chances. Their kicking in that second half, Pienaar and then Jackson at the end there, was absolutely pinpoint. A terrific performance and a full squad performance across every single player. Mark Anscombe will just be delighted. Look at that scoreboard. You would never have imagined that scoreboard before this, the start of this match. Magnificent from Ulster.
They came here hoping for something, a bonus point was the talk around the stadium for Ulster fans. And Montpellier looking for their 19th win in a row here at home. The first side to ever win a Heineken Cup game here at the Stade Yves de Manoir, Ulster. The result of some note. Taking into consideration Montpellier's home record and their budget, Ulster have dispatched one of the French big boys. And with back-to-back games against Treviso up next, then home to this Montpellier side, Ulster's destiny is now firmly in their own hands. A historic victory in France on the road for Ulster. They have beaten Montpellier 25 points to 8.